Welcome to Object Access, the third in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. Okay, so you've given users access to the organization by setting IP ranges and login hours. Now it's time to talk about access to objects. Profiles determine the objects a user can access and the permissions a user has on an object record. Profiles also control which tabs are visible and which apps are available in the app picker. Profiles also determine object access and what permissions users have to each object: create, read, edit, and delete. As we saw in the earlier video, organization access, the profile also contains system settings that control login hours and IP ranges. Salesforce provides standard profiles to get you started. These profiles may not be edited, but they can be cloned and then edited to create custom profiles. The most basic profile is the standard user. The standard user has create, read, edit, and delete permissions to most standard Salesforce objects, such as accounts, contacts, and opportunities. There are three additional profiles that are based on the standard user. These profiles build on the standard user profile with additional permissions for users in specific areas. There are two other special profiles: the read-only profile, which grants access to the same objects as the standard user profile, but limits permissions to read-only, and the system administrator profile. The system administrator profile has two superpowers: view all data and modify all data. These permissions override all sharing rules and settings, so use caution when granting these permissions to any other profiles besides the system administrator. Let's go into our practice organization for AW Computing to see how this works. In this demo, we're going to create a custom profile for the inside sales reps at AW Computing. First, we'll enable the Enhanced Profile User interface. This new interface makes navigation when creating profiles much easier. This setting is located under Customize, User Interface. Let's use the Quick Find box to locate profiles. Here we see a list of all the standard and custom profiles in our org. We'll clone the standard user profile to get started and name it. The profile interface is divided into two sections: app settings and system settings. App settings determine which apps are available to the user, which objects and tabs they have access to, and app-specific permissions, such as manage call centers for the call center app. System settings determine login hours and IP ranges for a particular profile, and determine system permissions. System permissions work across the entire app. They range from permissions like create and customize reports to edit read-only fields. We'll start with assigned apps. Our inside sales reps don't need access to the call center or marketing apps, so we'll deselect those, and we'll keep sales as the default app. Next, we'll set the permissions this profile has to objects. This drop-down arrow gives us access to both the app and the system settings, just as we saw on the previous page. We'll click Object Settings. We don't want inside sales to edit or delete accounts. That process is managed by our marketing team, so we'll clear the checkboxes. From the object pick list, we'll go to Contacts. We'll leave these settings as is. Since the inside salespeople are in touch with their clients, we want them to be updating contact records. From the object pick list, we'll go to Opportunities. We don't want inside salespeople to delete opportunities. If an opportunity is lost, we want to keep that record in the system so the sales team can evaluate its wins and losses. AW Computing uses chatter files and content for all document storage, so we don't want the salespeople to mistakenly use the documents object. We could just mark this tab as hidden, but users might still see records of this type in reports, dashboards, or in related lists. Since our goal is to prevent access to this object entirely, then we'll remove the read permission from the object permissions. We've just created a custom profile based on the standard profile that was provided by Salesforce. Now we'll assign this profile to Karen Adams, one of our inside salespeople. We'll also assign this profile to everyone else in inside sales. We can see which users are assigned to a profile by going to the profile list, clicking the profile in question, and viewing the list of assigned users. Great! We've just created a custom profile for our salespeople and assigned it to everyone on the inside sales team.